Good afternoon, students. Welcome in video lecture of employability and skill development. In this, we already started the unit number 6, problem solving technique. In this problem solving technique, we already discussing the point problem solving model. Today, we are going to discuss the remaining part of this problem solving model. I will once again introduce the problem solving model. The problem solving models are used to address the many challenges which are arising in the workplace or in our that means our industry, that our office or any kind of the organization. In that, whatever the problems are coming and whatever the challenges are coming, considered one, that to solve that challenge, to go through that challenge, this problem solving model, it is used one. See the structure of this particular problem solving model, as it provides the consistency, it ensures increase the collaborative teamwork, ideal for complex problems, as easy to repeat steps, is a process of continual improvement. This is some sort of the structure of this particular problem solving model. By considering this structure, and here already I said that this problem solving model, it has 6 steps. From that 6 steps, that means total we are having 6 steps. From that, we already discussed in previous lecture that 3 steps, which are, I will once again repeat that names. First is the define the problem, then gather the information, then third is the identify various solutions. These 3 we are already discussed one, and today we are going to discuss the remaining 3 steps which are considered in this problem solving model. Now we will see one by one these 3 steps, or the exactly we are calling is as the models, and from that 4th step, it is our 4th model, it is the evaluate alternatives. See, up till now what we are done, we are defined the exactly the problem, then we are we can say that evaluated that particular, we have gone through that particular problem with gathering the information, how, why it is happened and all that thing. That means all the things we are considered one, and after that we are trying to come with some solutions, not only single solution, with n number of solution, and which may be applied for that particular problem. So this work we already done one. Then from, by considering that steps, we are going to consider the next step as the evaluate alternatives. In this step, whatever the teamwork or groups, whatever the team members or the groups, what they are going to do, they are evaluate all these selected and selected potential solutions. Whatever that they are defined the n number of solutions, that means more than one solution they are considered one. To a single solution it will not work, that will not that much effectively give the results. For that they gone to come with that particular some sort of the more solutions, okay, and narrow it down in a single one. That means they are again combined whatever the solutions they are defined one, they are again coming from that particular one, single narrow solutions, by considering all the solutions. And by considering from that whatever the they are considered the solution, from that whatever they are coming with the one solution, okay, for this solution, this step applies mainly 2 questions. Which one? Which solution is the most feasible? That means see what I am going to see here. Whatever the solution they are defined one, from that which one is the feasible one, which one is the best one, which one in which is the you can see that give the proper result, that we have to, that means that it is defined in this particular. And then next question is the which solution is favored by those who will implement and use it. That means whatever the group members are there, whatever the team members are there, which solution they are going to consider, right? And that they want to implement for that particular problem. That means they are choosing the best solution for that particular problem. So here, I said that the groups evaluate all the selected and potential solution and narrow it down to one. That means they are coming with the best solution from that particular selected solution. That is the thing it is done in this particular step. So I just figure out the how they are considering these steps as the judge feasibility. Then from that they will select the best and they will come with the proper chosen solution. So that this evaluation process, it completes one. This particular evaluation process or that alternatives, it is completes one. This is the fourth step. Now, by considering the fourth step, fourth model, now it's time to apply that particular solution on that particular problem. That means exactly we are implementing that particular task. So here, fifth model is the take action. That means we are putting a solution into action which may prove as difficult as deciding on one, right? It will prove as deciding as one. It means what happened? This solution, it is very difficult task for this process, this action taking, it is a some sort of the very difficult task as compared to taking the decision. So here we are directly implementing whatever the chosen solution, best solution. And this stage, for this particular thing, to do this particular thing, this stage requires some sort of the action planning. Without action planning, you can't do this particular task. Which then action planning it is considered one? See here, this action planning which is developed by the group members. Here, what they are developed on, what they are considered in this action plan as, what must be done by considering that particular solution, what must be done, who will do this particular, then when will be it started one, when will get that particular key milestone to completed one, how will the necessary action to be carried out, and why are these actions necessary, these all things are planned one. Without considering this thing, we can't take the action, because what we are deciding, what we are considering, that from the n number of solutions, we are considering the one single solution, we are coming with the best solution, single solution in the sense, by judging, we are considering the best solution. And to get that particular proper result, we are now taking the action by considering that solution of that particular problem. By that particular problem. So the team sees to it that the action plan developed is carried out with the some sort of the documentation also. That means by considering this thing, that particular team is coming with that documentary work also. See how the chart it is giving that particular idea about the this action plan. To take the actions, that team members have to agree with that particular plan. Then plan sets out the action required before, during implementation of that particular solution. Then here you have to apply some sort of the tools which are considered as, or which are here considered as the Gantt's chart or timeline or log frame can be used as the tool for that particular action taking thing. And then finally we have to start or consider the that particular milestone. By considering that particular milestone, we have to start the date for the determining that. Like that, we have to take the action on this particular solution. So the fifth is the important thing after the that you can say that fourth stage. Now, by considering the all these stages, whatever the one to fifth one, now it's time to consider the action, evaluation of that particular action. Right. See here, after four, that means by considering the solution, then we are coming with that particular best solution. by considering the when we have to apply that particular solution, that means the taking the action, how and in which manner, all these things by considering the action plan. Now it's time to take the, you can say that after applying that particular solution on the project, we have to take the evaluation action. That means sixth stage we have to consider one. Whatever the thing which is done in the fifth stage, that means we are taking directly, we are applying the direct that particular solution on that particular problem, that is the action. We are starting that particular project by considering the solution. By considering that particular solution, we are going to solve the problem. So after that, we have to come with some sort of the result, and that point it is considered in the sixth stage. This sixth stage is the evaluate the actions. Whatever the action we are taking, on that we have to do the some sort of the evaluative task work. Okay, so the project implementation now needs to be monitored one. That means whatever the we are applying that particular solution on the problem, that should be, we have to need to monitor one, right? And that group, it ensures that whatever the they are recommended point in that particular action plan, that particular selection of the best solution, that or whether these are followed or not, they have to ensure from this particular evaluation point. And this particular evaluation action evaluation, it consists some sort of the checking. It includes some sort of the checklist, you can say that. This monitor includes the checking. Which checking? Whether that milestones are met, cost are contained, necessary work is completed. These are the main things are considered under this particular evaluate the action. Right? So in this sixth stage, what we are doing, whatever the up till now, up to fifth stage, whatever the group members are doing one, by considering the different definition, defining the problem onwards, gathering information, considering some sort of the solutions, then coming from that particular right best solution, then implementing, or you can see that taking action by considering that solution on that particular problem, okay, and applying that problem on that particular, by considering that particular solution, by all these things, the group member come with this particular action evaluative point, right? And for that, what they are considering, the main things are milestones are whether it is met one, whatever the costs are contained, whether it is getting one or not, and whatever the missing work, it is considered one, right? Whether it is completed by considering this action or not. These things are they are going to judge when with their whatever the recommendations and their whatever the things are considered in that particular points, right? In that particular steps. So this whatever the evaluation of that particular action, this whatever the thing it is considered, it might be considering the taking the feedback. That means whatever the this team members are there, or the group members are there, they will consider the feedback mechanism for the diagnosing that particular result. They will detect the project which is considered for that particular solution, whether it is giving that particular smooth result or not, right? And for that, they consider the feedback mechanism, some additional tools they are considering to get that particular right result, right? Sometimes what happens, apart from this particular thing, many group members, what they are doing, they are considering the fifth whatever the stages are considered for that problem solving, they are considering only this much, and sixth stage they are not taking that much care about the sixth stage. But the thing will what happens, whatever the things are considered in the up to fifth plan, might be it will not achieved at the sixth one. At that case, it may happens if they are skipping the this sixth stage. So it is said that whenever you are considering the problem solving model, at that time be ensure that you have to follow all the things. That means you have to consider the action on that particular evaluated point. That means whatever the implement implementation you are doing, okay, for that, again, for that particular actions, you have to get the proper analysis to get that particular result. So this sixth step is also very important, right? So they also ensure the project is not introducing a new problem during this particular process, right? They will get that particular thing here. So here, I displayed one that particular small chart which gives the steps for that particular getting the result, right? That means during that particular evaluation of the actions. So here, success relies on implementation process being monitored and data collected to ensure outcome is attained. See feedback mechanism to ensure that these things, and then you can get that particular main things as the whether you get that particular milestones are met or not, costs are contained or not, or work, whatever the necessary work it is considered one, whether it is implemented or completed in a proper manner or not. This will come through this particular point of view. So by considering this step, you can realize that whatever this problem solving model is there, whether it is getting that much result or not, that means whatever the things are considered for that solving the problems, it is getting that much good result or not, it will be, you can say that considered one. And definitely I say that here, by considering these steps, including the sixth one, you will get the better, you can see that result on that particular problem by considering this stage. Now, by considering these six steps model, that means overall, by considering these six steps model, it is a very simple and reliable way to, you can say that, solve the problem, right? Which will again help that particular team members to track and enables them to go through the investigation of that particular problem so that they can come with the better result, right? This is the, you can see that, some sort of the advantage, or you can see that whatever the, you can see that from the point of view as the conclusion from this particular problem solving model. So students, this is the all about this particular problem solving model. And if you are having any doubts related to this problem solving model, then you can ask me anytime. So once again, thank you, and study well for these particular points. Thank you.